Chapter 6, Colonialism and the City. Colonialism and the City. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the story of an imperial capital. How was the capital built? What happened to the capital during the imperial rule? Now, moving on into the details. What happened to the cities? We have discussed in the previous lessons. What happened across the countryside? The Britishers have entered into the villages. They have divided the entire village lands into zamindars' control. They have followed certain methods for tax collection, like the permanent settlements, the Raitwari system, the Mahalwari systems. Well, ultimately, all the systems have failed. They could not get much profit from the countryside. Then, parallelly, during this period, what happened in the cities? If we talk about the cities, we would be very clear, like, about which city we are talking. The development of each city has its own reasons and its own drawbacks. For example, if I take a city like Madurai, where it is a temple town, the development of Madurai as a temple town reasons would be different to that of a city like Dhaka, where the Britishers established the manufacturing units here. Due to the establishment of the manufacturing units, the people started to migrate towards that region where the units are established in search of opportunities. Then they started to settle on nearby places, and then the city got emerged like this. So people migrated due to the manufacturing unit established in Dhaka, availability of the jobs in Dhaka. But when it comes to Madurai, temple town, many of the people used to come and visit the temple town. As many of the people are coming here, the basic facilities providing for them. So many stalls might have been come up. Many skilled people might have been staying there during the construction of the temple town or the temples in the town. And as the time passed on, these people started to establish hotels or resting places for them. And like this, the commercial activity has increased across the temple region, and the town emerged like that. So, the reasons for the emergence of the temple town are clearly different when come to the reasons of establishing an industrial town here. So, like this, it starts varying. Now, coming to western side, the European countries, towns and cities got emerged because of industrialization, which happened from 1718 to 1820, where many industries got established and people moved close to that areas, and these regions became more crowded. In the late 19th century, we have the cities which got emerged in the western side, emerging as the capital cities or the important towns of trade due to industrialization. But in India, we have the new towns coming up as the presidency cities. What are the presidency cities? The cities which are used for the administrative purpose, the cities which are established and through which the administration is run across in that particular state is known as presidency city. Like, in simple terms, we can call them as capital cities. Like that, we have the emergence of Bombay, Bengal and Madras. For different provinces, they became the presidency cities. During this establishment of the presidency cities, we can now focus our attention towards the older towns of our country. The older towns of our country are Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam. Machilipatnam is now the headquarters of Krishna district, which is very closely connected with Vijayawada, just across 50 to 70 kilometers away from Vijayawada's mainland. Now, Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam were initial points where the Britishers established their trade points or settlements, did their trade. From Machilipatnam, they used to do the trading, exports and imports. Through Surat port, they used to do the trading. And Seringapatnam, down in the Karnataka region also, they used to do trading here. But as the emergence of the new presidency cities here, Bombay, Bengal and Madras, the people started to shift from Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam towards the towns which got emerged as new cities, that is Bombay, Bengal and Madras, due to various reasons. One, due to get the convenient places for them. Second, they may get some administrative opportunities for them to work in the administrative offices. So in search of these jobs or these situations, people start to migrate from many villages to these places. And this led to the de-urbanization of the cities Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam, and urbanization of the cities of Bombay, Bengal and Madras. What is urbanization and what is de-urbanization? Urbanization, people move from villages to towns, from rural areas to urban areas. With this, the urban areas get more populated than the rural areas. So getting more populated from the rural areas means the migration of the people from the urban areas to the rural areas is not at all happening anywhere. People migrate from rural areas to urban areas. When people are migrating from rural areas to urban areas, that is called urbanization. When people are migrating from urban area, the town where it got urbanized, from here, if they are moving to some other place, not to the village back, people moving from this particular city or town to the newly emerged cities, like for example, from Machilipatnam to Madras, then this urbanized Machilipatnam is now getting de-urbanized. Now people are moving from here, they are going to Madras. People are moving from Seringapatnam, going to Bengal or Bombay. So people are moving from Surat, going to Bombay. So the urbanized places still now are Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam. But now as the situation is changing, people started to migrate from these places which are already urbanized. From here they are moving to other places. So again we cannot call it as urbanization. Once people are moving from rural areas to urban areas, we can call it as urbanization. But now people are moving from urbanized places only to another places. This is called de-urbanization. So de-urbanization of the cities of Machilipatnam, Surat and Seringapatnam happened during the early 19th century because of the establishment of the presidency cities like Bombay, Bengal and Madras.